So let's talk about screencasting. Now, when we talk about screencasting, what does that exactly mean? So, screencasting really is literally recording the screen of the device that you are using. It's as simple as that. You can record the screen of the device that you are using, like I am now, using PowerPoint and a software called Camtasia. Or you can also use a screencasting app on an iPad or Android device. And this allows you to do the same thing as record the screen of the iPad or the device that you are using. However, with the application, it has added elements where you can add text, audio, images, and you can also draw on the screen to add more detail. Now, this just gives it another whole new dimension. So, screencasting then becomes particularly valuable to the education arena. So, if we think about screencasting for teachers, teachers can screencast any of their lessons ahead of time, and then if they were doing group work, they could have one group of students using a pre-recorded screencasting app to give them directions on what the teacher wants them to do. Now, that becomes really valuable because the teacher can be working with other students, but the group of students with the screencasting app and the devices really still have the teacher's instruction right there in front of them. So, screencasting can also be used for flip teaching. Now, essentially, flip teaching is flipping the classroom around. These apps become particularly invaluable for flip teaching because, again, the teacher can pre-record any of the lessons, concept ideas, presentations, work, homework, anything really that they want to ahead of time. And then when the students are home, they can open up their device and refer back to what the teacher has pre-recorded and then do their work from there. So then what happens is when they come back to the classroom, the hard work's already been done and the classroom time can be used for more creative type things, more discussions, presentations, working around the ideas, mind mapping, any of those things that become a more collaborative piece of work in the classroom. Screencasting apps can be used for differentiation. Now, this was one of the most valuable things that I discovered when I introduced iPads to my classroom was that I could use my applications and change them for each and every student depending on where their ability level was at and depending on their learning style. And for those students who are really visual learners, I found that screencasting apps worked really well for them. And with students, particularly who have autism, this is really important because they do learn very visually. So rather than them coming up to me, every 5 minutes or needing me there one-on-one with them, I could pre-record the concept that I'm wanting them to learn, and they can just keep referring back to it at any time that they want. So it becomes an incredibly invaluable tool, not only for the students' work, but also for me as a teacher. It's just become such a time-saving tool for me to be able to use in the classroom. I can use screencasting apps for remediation. So again, I can pre-record any concept, learning idea, particularly for those kids who might be having trouble in a particular area, seeing it on the screen, me demonstrating it, drawing it, using my audio as well as the drawing capabilities that are on screencasting apps can be incredibly invaluable for students. Also, what's really great about that is that when they're home doing their homework and they've go, "Oh my God, what did Miss So and So say about that idea and how that worked?" And they can go to that screencasting pre-recorded lesson at any time and revisit what the teacher was wanting them to learn. Now, this also becomes really important for parents because a lot of times I hear from parents when they come to parent teacher interviews and they say, "Oh, I didn't know how to do that," or "I couldn't remember how to do long division or short division or algebra or whatever the subject area might be." And so the screencasting app and your pre-recorded lesson can become a really fantastic thing for parents to be able to revisit the learning concept, and then they can help their children more at home. Finally, teachers can also use screencasting apps for extension. For those kids who need extra work, this is a really easy way to be able to extend them. One, you could pre-record something else that you would like them to do, an extra activity, or you could say to them, "Go use the screencasting app and record now what you've learned in this particular lesson. And then they have to retell what they've learned. Okay, let's move on. Students can use screencasting apps to present their work to the teacher. This just gives the students some variety in the way that they can present their work. Some kids do have problems with writing things down and getting everything down on paper. And it's just a great way for those kids who are much more visual, much more creative in the way that they're speaking, that they can use a screencasting app and tell the teacher what they've learned. And then you get an idea that, oh, okay, they're not really as far behind as I thought. So I think it's a great alternative. As mentioned before, students can do their homework using a screencasting app. They can share ideas with each other. So one of the extension type activities that you can allocate to your students is, if you finished your work, get together as a group, do a screencast and share with each other what you have learned. Now this becomes really invaluable, because what one student has learned, another student may learn something completely different. And so they're extending their learning by conversation and using this particular application. You can also use screencasting apps for peer tutoring, where students pair together and share with each other what they've learned. And this is just a fantastic way for collaboration and sharing of ideas. And as I mentioned before, what one student learns, another student may see it in a completely different way. So that way, they're getting kind of two heads working together. And I think it's a fantastic way of learning. Now, oral presentations, I think this is really invaluable for our students, because some kids are really nervous speakers, and our speaking and listening aspect of our literacy program can get lost a little bit because of this. So what I actually mean by that is that we tend not to do as much speaking and listening, I think, as perhaps we should. We focus a lot on reading and writing, but not so much on expression and conversation and communication. And you have those really, really shy kids who struggle when it comes to oral presentations. And I think there's some quote somewhere that says, you know, that public speaking has one of the highest degrees of causing anxiety in people. So the same goes for students. Now, I think that what makes this app really good for those kids is that they can then do their oral presentation using a screencasting app. They're using the audio function to share their ideas and do the oral work. And then when they present it to their classroom, they have that buffer of being able to use the screencasting app. And then what happens then is that then builds their confidence. And from building their confidence, then takes it to the next level, and you are going to be able to challenge them more, and they're more likely to want to do the oral presentations in the future. You may need to get them to do this, you know, 2, 3, 4 times. It could be half a year of getting them to do that. But the idea, I would think, would be to extend them and then get them to eventually overcome their fear and anxiety and present their work orally in front of their peers. So that just gives you a very quick overview of what screencasting is. And now we're going to look at some screencasting apps in more detail.